who work with PCP or pre-charged air rifles will know what this is. This is diver's tank, and it's what 99.9% of us charge our pre-charged air rifles with. Now, they're quite heavy. They hold about 3,000 PSI, some even more than that. And due to their round shape, they're anything but easy to get to sit still on a flat surface. So, I made one of these here, which is a simple little cradle made out of MDF, and it'll let you be able to store the tank without it rolling around the place, falling over, and even transporting it in the boot of your car. So I'll show you how to make that now. Now, you don't need too much timber for this project, just these four pieces here, and these two larger pieces will be cut in half later on. Now, this is 18mm thick MDF. Now, you can use plywood or whatever you can get a howl of. Even if you can get it wider than 18mm, all the better. It'll add strength to it. These are just some pieces that we're laying around the workshop and I'm making use of. Now, plywood and MDF usually come in fairly large sheets, usually 8 feet by 4 feet, which is quite large for this sort of project. But some hardware and DIY stores will sell it to you in smaller pieces, and some will even cut them to the sizes you need if you don't have the facilities at home, which is very useful. Now, these two pieces are going to be the sides, and they're roughly 6.25 inches across, or 158mm. Lengthwise, 11.25 inches, or 285mm. These two are going to be the end pieces, and they are roughly 9.5 inches across, or 240mm, and 12 5/8 lengthwise inches, or 320mm. You'll also need a couple of different sizes of wood screw. This is a 4x60mm long wood screw, and this is a 4x30mm long wood screw, both countersunk and designed for wood or chipboard. You'll need a 3mm drill piece and a countersunk bit, or if you're fortunate enough to have a drill and countersinker combination piece, all the better. As well as the drill bits, you're going to need a battery screwdriver or drill, plus a jigsaw and some decent wood glue.
First, take the two larger 9.5 by 12 5/8 boards and draw a line from corner to corner with a ruler to help find the centre of the board. Then square a line across the middle of this through the centre. Now you need to find the diameter of your tank by simply butting two boards up against either side and measure the distance between them. In my case, it's 7 inches or 178mm. Then with a ruler, mark 3.5 inch or 89mm either side of the central mark. Then set a compass to this point. And draw a circle. Then measure it again with a ruler to ensure it is the right diameter. Then cut the two boards exactly in half down the central line. I have already allowed a few millimetre for the width of the saw track. Once cut, mark the two boards so that you don't mix the two halves up. Front and back, 1 and 2. Then bore a 3mm countersunk hole on either side of the semicircle, ensuring that you're a good half 3/4 of an inch in from the edges so you don't split the timber, and then a third one down at the centre of the bottom. Match the two front and back pieces up together. Then screw them together with a 4x30mm long wood screw. Then lock them securely into the vise and cut them out with a jigsaw. Take your time when doing this. Try and follow the line as exactly as possible. Once you've cut both pieces out, try them on the tank for fit. They should be reasonably snug. If they're too tight though, lock the two of them into the vise and take a piece of sandpaper wrapped around a piece of piping and sand the pieces wherever needed to get them to fit the tank. Then take the two pieces and take the 4x30mm long screws out to split them into two halves again. Then taking one of the side pieces, hold it flush along the outside edge of one of the front semicircular cut pieces and mark a line 18mm in from the edge. Then, either with a ruler or a finger gauge like me, draw a line roughly down the center of this. This is basically a guide that you can use to keep your screw holes in the center of the board behind it that it is going to be screwed to. Then bore three 3mm countersunk holes down this line, ensuring that the top and bottom hole are about an inch in from the ends, as to stop splitting the board that the screws are going into behind it. Once you have both boards screwed like this, apply plenty of glue on the backboard, ensuring that it is the match to the front board when you were cutting it with the jigsaw. Then using the 4x30mm long screws, screw the two back together again. Using a 3mm drill bit, drill the three holes down either side, all the way through both boards. Then take the sideboards and butt them up against the back of the semicircular cut boards so that they are flush with the outside edge. Then run the 3mm drill bit back through the three holes along the outside edge so that they cut a hole into the end grain of the sideboards. And of course, mark which corners go to which corners so that you don't get them mixed up. The holes will help ensure that the screws will not split the end of the sideboards. Then apply a good bead of glue to the end grain of the sideboards. Butt it up against the back of the semicircular cut boards, ensuring that it is the matching corners that you drilled the 3mm bit through. Then put some of the screws into a wee bit of grease to help cut them into the MDF and insert them by hand into the holes, ready to be drilled in. Start with one corner at a time, lining them up and then screwing the screw in to hold it in place. Then line the other corner up, tighten in the screw and leave the middle one to the end. Do this to all four corners. It's a bit boring to watch, I know, but you get the point. Once everything's glued and screwed together, take a piece of sandpaper wrapped around a wooden block and sand off any of the sharp edges. Then square a line up from the bottom, about halfway along the sides. Measure up 1.5 inches or 40mm. And drill a 1 inch or 25mm hole. If you don't have a 25mm bit, you can just cut a nick in the bottom of the base. Then take a piece of sandpaper and sand off the sharp edges around the hole. Set the tank into place and take an 18 inch or 460mm bungee cord, one of the ones with wee metal ends, and bend the hook out a wee bit with a set of pliers to help it locate into the hole easier. Stretch it out over the tank and this will help hold it in place. Once finished, you'll have something you can support the tank while you transport it in the boot of your car, or even when you're safely storing it at home in your own gun room.